to see different women from different parts of the background, and that is what it should look like. So before I even begin, could we give ourselves a round of applause? Thank you so much to the organizers. I draw my attention to a wonderful volunteer, Ogi, who told me about this this particular program. And she insisted I needed to be here to support Drive Change, especially for the African, Afro-Caribbean, and Asian women. And she was very particular in terms of me meeting the Latin America women, and she insisted that I should be here. Apologies for my lateness today, but I found you in the end. I want to draw back to some of the key speakers that I've just sat down here listening, and thank you so much to the statistics from the gentleman from Sierra Leone, an absolutely wonderful lady who has begun to address the issues in Nigeria. I want to follow in as I walk into this room, but pay attention to what I will be saying, because my stuff is right at the back over there. But I want to tell stories. African and Asian people tell stories. And we tell our stories in a very special way. We tell our stories through what we do and what we don't do. I'm originally from Kenya, and this is the flag of Kenya. So I want to start off by telling the story of my people in Kenya and coming back all the way from Africa. Africa is made out of 54 countries, as you would know. In Africa, we are always being told the story of disease and the struggles of Africans and all kinds of things. And so is Asia and God knows what. I want to draw about the issues of the world and the peace issues that we are seeing here. And I want to draw back the summary of all the things that you've heard in this room. And thank you so much to every single person that is always thinking about what the world should look like. And I feel that there is a responsibility in every single one person of us. We need to change all our mindset and think about the issues of if we all respect this world and what a good world it should look like and what is a good world to you as a person. And I think regardless of which background that you come from, you are going to realize that there is one thing in common, and that thing is to respect our planet and to respect love as humanity and embrace and champion the issues that surround us all at once. I want to address the issues of us as a diaspora. We travel from the Far East, from the Far Asia, as you've heard from Nola over there. And she picked the example of Nigeria, that recycling is something that is recycled. So I want us to take one of the leads and suggestions that she has brought in. And I brought in the conclusion. I was asked to speak about sustainability in environment across Africa and how this compares to Europe and the UK. And thank you so much to the people of Sierra Leone and, of course, the people of Somali, the lady over here from Somali and the lady over there from Nigeria. And now myself from Kenya, and definitely all of you from all kind, from all different backgrounds. So I want to compare the issues and summarize quickly. So are we ready for change? That is the question I'm going to ask you right now here. Is our mindset ready to assist us as human beings and as people, whether we are referred to people as color, what advantage and what preciousness do we have? I want to ask us about our organic food. In Africa, I want to celebrate the organic farms that we celebrate in food eating. But we come here, I believe that we have also sometimes picked up the habits of bad habits, and we know where that leads us to. How responsible are we in our own behaviors and characters? And I have asked that question, and our mindset. So I want to leave you with, as a people, where do you stand in your families? As a people, where do you, you've heard about promoting the SDG goals. I want to ask us carefully, you know, even in schools here, has a priority for us. I have had, if people can be told that you have to think about your sex, I believe that, you know, and I'm comparing, and I want to go a little bit like devil's advocate. If we go to schools and our children are being told to think about whether you're a boy and girl, sometimes we have to ask ourselves, is that what we're really championing? Or are we championing the issues of climate issues? And are we serious about championing the issues of climate matters? I want us as a people, as we live here, not just to come out here and think that this is just another meeting, but to create sustainability in a special home, in our special homes, as Nola has started. Recycling, that is what she's talking about. Food wastage, that is what he's talking about. When you go and you're buying stuff, think about what you're putting even here in as a person. Thank you so much for every single thing. Are you also paying attention to Brexit matters and Brexit issues? You know, when we think about Brexit matters and Brexit issues, we are thinking about how does that support Africa? How does that support Asia? And I think to just leave it there, be the champion of climate matters, make women the progressive people that they are meant to be.